Morning, folks. Welcome to the seventh game of the Reading Rockets D squad, where they will be taking on Acton Boxborough. It's a rainy day, cloudy and overcasty, but see if the Rockets can get a chance here to bring one home. So it's a kickoff, and the Reading Rocket D squad returns it down to about midfield, where they'll take over first and 10. Rockets come to the line of scrimmage.
Number 50, Jason Anderson. Number 42, Vedant Naranjan. Number 41, Sean Crowley.
Rocco Masciarelli is the quarterback. He keeps the ball for a nice pickup of about 6 yards on the play. Brings it down to about the Colonial 45.
Number 8.
Rockets come out. Masciarelli under center. He's going to keep it himself. He's got some blocking.
Number 7, Brendan Lindmark.
Nice running by Rocco Masciarelli. Number 72, Sean Murphy in there to make a great block. Along with number 81, Zachary Galvin. And that's enough for a first down. Rockets come out in a wide receiver slot left. And Masciarelli's going to keep it himself. He's looking for some room. And the Colonials do a pretty good job there of stopping him behind the line of scrimmage for a loss on the play. And it's going to be second down. The Rockets looking to convert here on first down, trying to figure it out. Masciarelli getting direction from Beckenhuis. And he's going to keep it himself again. He's got some room on the outside. He's eventually stopped by the Colonials. And they're going to have a nice big third down here. Third and about 7 to go.
Number 8.
Third down, 7 yards to go. Masciarelli under center. No, I'm sorry, that's Beckenhuis under center. He's going to keep it. Looking to get past the chains, and he does. Great job by Aiden Beckenhuis to follow his blockers along the outside and pick up the first down to keep the drive alive. First and 10 Rockets. The Rockets are driving here. They're at the Colonial 24-yard line. And Beckenhuis is going to keep it himself again. He stopped after about a yard on the play, bringing up second and about 9. Rockets come up to the line of scrimmage. And a nice trap play to Nowicki. Completely caught the Colonials off guard. And he's able to get into the end zone for a touchdown, putting the Rockets up 6-0, the first to go in. And great, great job, great execution by the entire offensive line to get Nowicki into the end zone. 6-0 Rockets. As they go for the extra attempt. And they're going to try to go for it again. Nope, this time it's a keeper. And Masciarelli keeps it himself. So the Rockets trying a little bit different approach here on offense. And it's, so far it's worked. And they will be kicking off. Rockets kick off to the Colonials. He's still on his feet. Uh-oh, he's following his blockers here. And finally brought down by number 7, Brendan Lindmark, who attempted to go for the strip, it looked like, on that play. But nonetheless, he's able to tackle it, and the Rockets will now go on defense. Acton Boxborough comes up to the line of scrimmage. They've got a 2-receiver set, 1 running back, quarterback under center. He gives the ball to the running back, who goes up the field for about 3 or 4 yards on the play, but Rocco Masciarelli did a nice job in the solo tackle. Bring up second down. This time the Colonials come out 1 receiver set to the right. And again, the give is to the running back who runs immediately into number 8, Mascherelli, looked like number 6, Iapica. Number 50, Anderson, was also on the play to bring up a 3rd and about 3. It's time the Colonials come out back in the 2-receiver set. Interesting position where they've got the wide receiver way back, slot left. I don't know about that positioning, but it's a nice stop on 3rd and about 4. It's going to bring a 4th down and about 2 to go. And I would bet that the coaches are going to go for it here, Kev. We will certainly see. But 4th down, as the Colonials will try to convert here. Obviously, the Rockets hoping to stop them. So we'll see. Back in the 2-receiver split set, and a QB sneak. And he's trying, he's chucking his feet. This is gonna be a close one. Waiting for a referee signal. I don't know if they're gonna bring out the chains or, yeah, they are. They're gonna do a measurement on this one. So this is a close one. We'll see what the spot does. All right. So the Rockets are able to stop the Colonials on a 4th and 2, as the refs had to bring out the chains to measure it, but great job by the defense, as the Rockets will now take over on offense, 1st and 10 from their own 28. Rockets come out to the line of ball, come up to the line of scrimmage. They've got Centrella at quarterback, who gives it to Mascherelli. And there's a fumble on the play. And the Colonials jump on the ball. And an unfortunate turnover there, as they are able to take possession. And they will now go 1st and 10 from about the 30. All right. See if the Rocket defense can stop them again here. They did a great job last time. And the quarterback's dumping back. Oh, it almost looked like an interception there, but the Colonial receiver was able to hang on to the ball. It looked like number, I don't know if that was Beckham Hughes. I'm not sure. It's hard to tell. Maybe Jack James. I see number 40 out there. He was involved in the play. So 2nd and 5. All right. Quarterback going back. He's looking to go deep. And Iapica was back there in decent coverage, but the Colonial receiver was able to hang on to the football and convert the 1st down. So the Colonials, as they take a timeout, will have it 1st and 10. On the Rocket, it's like 20 or 11 yard line. Is it the? All right, we'd like to look at our first player profile of the game. We're going to look at number 6, Giacomo Iapica. Giacomo goes to the Joshua Eaton Elementary School. His favorite food is steak. Great choice. His superhero, is Antonio Brown. And when he's not playing football, he enjoys water and snow skiing. And when he grows up, he wants to play in the NFL as a professional football player. That's number 6, Giacomo Iapica, doing a great job this year. So the Colonials get the ball 1st and 10. They get about 2 yards on the play. No, not even. Maybe about a yard, if that, on the play. It's going to be 2nd and 10 for the Colonials, as they're at the Rocket 13. They come out in the shotgun set. The ball is given to the cornerback, the running back, rather, for a gain of about 2 yards on the play.
Number Number 24, Cameron McGinty on the run that hit.
Colonials once again come out in the shotgun set. Two backs to his side. He gives it to one of the backs. The back is trying to follow his blockers, and looks like number 21, Beckenhuis. And number 81, Zachary Galvin on the stop to bring up fourth and one as the Colonials will try to obviously get in the end zone, but more importantly, get the first down. They only need a yard to do it. Let's see if the Rockets can hold them here. They come out in an I formation. Quarterback under center. The give is to the tailback. He's trying to plow ahead, and I do believe he got the first down. He's not in the end zone, but he did get the first down. So it's going to be first and goal from the 1 yard line. Colonials come up to the line of scrimmage. Rocket defense desperately trying to stop him. Looks like Beckenhuis was on the stunt there. Nice job. Pile still moving. Nope. Stop. He's not in the end zone. Second down. All right. Rockets will try to stop him again. Colonials are able to get into the end zone for a touchdown as they tie the score. As they go up by 6 points to make the score 7, Rockets 6, Colonials. Colonials are going to try for the kick here. You don't see this too often at the D level. And the attempt is no good, but I did like the attempt. As the score will remain 7 Rockets, 6 Colonials. All right, the Rockets set to return. You got number 3, Braden Nowicki. Number 7, Brendan Lindmark back deep. The ball is kicked to the second level where it will be pounced on by number 8 and number 6, Rocco Muscarelli and Giacomo Iapica, giving the Rockets a first down on their own 42-yard line. All right, the Rockets come up to the line of scrimmage. They've got Muscarelli at quarterback. He's going to keep it himself. He's got some room. And really an awesome job by the offensive line in the blockers to give Muscarelli a lot of room. You had number 81, Zachary Galvin, number 54, Dylan Burpee, number 80, Dylan Sweetser, and a host of number 72, Sean Murphy, all contributing to the blocking on that play. So first down for the Rockets. Who else we got on that line? Rockets come out again. Muscarelli under center. He's going to give it this time to number 21, Aiden Beckenhuis. Number 7, Brendan Lindmark out there to lead the block, along with number 54, Dylan Burpee, as the Rockets call a timeout. All right. Rockets trying to keep the drive alive here. They got it first and 10. They're inside of Colonial territory at the 28-yard line. Muscarelli, number 8, keeps it himself. But this time a Colonial defender was able to get in there and tackle him behind the line of scrimmage. So loss of one on the play, but still second down. All right, Rockets come back to line of scrimmage. They're in almost like a moose formation. They're going to give it to Nowicki on the trap play again. This time the Colonials were not fooled. They had seen it before and got burned on a touchdown with it, but not this time, as they stop Nowicki behind the line of scrimmage. Loss of about a yard on the play. It's going to bring up third and about 13 as there's a timeout on the field. All right. Rockets want to convert here. They got 13 yards to do it. Mascherelli under center. He is going to keep it this time. Get some positive yards out of it. Not enough for the first. He's going to be short about 7 yards. So fourth and 7. The Rockets are inside of Colonial Territory. They're at the 29-yard line. Call it the 30. No, I'm sorry, the 25-yard line. Come up to the line of scrimmage. Two-back set. Mascherelli's going to keep it. He's got some room. And he's got the first down. So once again, Mascherelli putting his head down and taking advantage of a great hole that the offensive line and the blockers give him. Enough for a first down. So great job. First and 10, Rockets. Nowicki keeps the ball. Actually, may have it.
Number 3, Brandon Nowicki.
The Rockets trying to drive here, get in the end zone. Mascherelli's going to keep it himself. He's got plenty of room. Great job by the Rocket offensive line, the right side of the line there to open up the hole.
It is now 13-6.
Number 6, Iapica. Number 7, Lindmark. Number 72, Murphy. Number 21, Beckenhuis. All excellent job to open up that right side of the line to get Mascherelli into the end zone as they go up 13-6. All right, the Rockets on the attempt. They're going to try to keep it. Beckenhuis, he gets in. So an excellent drive by the Reading Rockets as they go up 14-6. So this player profile, we're going to look at number 5. Number 5 is Quinn Dolan. And Quinn is a Quinn goes to the Parker Middle School. And his favorite food is tacos. His favorite superhero is Odell Beckham Jr., the one-handed catch man. And when he's not playing football, his favorite thing to do is hang out with his friends. And when he grows up, he would like to play in the NFL as well. So that is number 5, Quinn Dolan. So the Rockets will kick off. Number 6, Giacomo Iapica doing the honors as usual. Does a great job, always. See if he can boot it way down there. And nice kick into the second level. It's going to get a nice bounce. The Colonial player picks it up. And he's trying to get outside. Beckenhuis in pursuit. Giacomo Iapica in pursuit. And he's bouncing off a couple Rocket defenders. But he's finally brought down after a nice return by, looked like number 5, Quinn Dolan, actually made the tackle on that. So, nice little return, and ultimately a great stop by the Rockets to bring up first and 10 for the Colonials. All right. Rockets come out, standard 5-3 set. Flag on the play. Got a false start against the Colonials. I mean, didn't see that, but refs are going to back them up. Be first and 15. All right. First and 10 as they get a 5 yards out of the, first and 10 as they get 5 yards. It's going to be first and 10. Okay, the Rockets trying to stop him here on 2nd and 12. The quarterback's going to pass. Ball's in the air. Nice attempt as it drops incomplete. 3rd down. Colonials come out there. Quarterback is under center. They've got a tight offensive set. Ball's on the ground. And the quarterback smartly jumps on the ball to retain possession as the Rockets will take a timeout on fourth down.
Fourth and 13 for the Colonials.
All right, the Colonials come out. We were trying to figure out if they were going to punt or not, but they're going to go for it on fourth and about 12. Ball's in the air. Oh, baby. That was an excellent throw by the quarterback. And unfortunately, maybe it was the wet conditions, but the receiver was not able to hold on to the ball. He had it. He had the first down, but a fortunate break for the Rockets as they will get the ball first and 10. Wow. Rockets come up to the line of scrimmage. The ref calls a timeout, which is taken by Acton Boxborough.
Timeout Colonials.
All right, after the timeouts, Rockets come up to the line of scrimmage. Mascherelli at quarterback. This time he does give it to Nowicki on the reverse. The Colonials looking like they're trying to stop that. They're doing a good job of staying behind. And we've got an injury timeout on the field. All right, so number three, Braden Nowicki. Looks like he's going to be all right. Mascherelli's going to keep it himself. He's looking to get a couple yards out of the play. Gets back to the line of scrimmage. It's going to be third down and about 7 yards to go. All right. Third down. Beckenhuis is going to keep it himself. He's trying to follow his blockers. Number 80, Dylan Sweetser out there to help out. Number 72, Sean Murphy. And we got a timeout on the field. Looks like Colonials. All right, the Rockets on fourth down are going to try to pass. And a great one-handed catch.
Pass from number 8.
By number 71, the lineman, Colin Donahue to get the first down. A really nice play by both Mascherelli and Donahue to connect on that. Mascherelli's going to keep it again. Gets about 7 or 8 yards on the play, so a nice job by the Rockets to keep the drive alive. As it's going to be second down. It looks like the Rockets are going to try to... Nope, we've got a timeout on the field. They were in the hurry up. We've got an injury timeout on the field. All right, Rockets. Time is moving down here. They're going to try to punch one in. Mascherelli's got some room along the outside, or at least he had some daylight, but the Colonial defender did a great job of sneaking in there and stopping him as I don't know if it looks like we do. We have halftime. Yeah, so that's it. So halftime on the field. So the Rockets go into half with the nice little lead, 14-6. Okay, as we start the second half, the Rockets will be kicking off. Number 6, Hayapika, again doing the honors. Colonial return man gets the ball. He brings it up to about his own 44-yard line where they'll take it first and 10. Okay, the Colonials take over on downs. First and 10, they're at their own 45-yard line. The quarterback is under center. The give is to the running back, but he's met immediately by number eight, Rocco Mascherelli, who did a great job of stepping up and stopping him for about a yard gain. It will be second down. Colonials come up to the line of scrimmage. This time they have an interesting wide receiver set where they're back about 5 yards from the line of scrimmage. Ball's on the ground, but the Colonials recover it. And it's a, yep, but a loss of one on the play. Third and 10. Colonials come up to the line of scrimmage, this time in the slot, split receiver set. This time they are close to the line of scrimmage. Quarterback is going to keep it himself. He gets about 4 yards on the play, but it's well short of the first down, leaving the Colonials in a 4th and 6 possession here, as the Rockets obviously going to try to stop him and take over on downs. So we'll see what the coach for AB calls here. They've been doing a pretty good job of sticking with the wide receiver set and trying to throw the Rockets off balance a little bit. They mix in a little bit of passing, mostly obviously run. And they are going back to the split receiver set. This time the far receiver well off the line of scrimmage, about 10 yards off the line of scrimmage. They are going to try to pass. Ball's in the air, and it's broken up by number 21. Aiden Beckenhuis, number 8, Rocco Masciarelli, number 41, Sean Crowley, number 6, Giacomo Iapica, all in there to make the play and give the Rockets a first down. Rockets come up to the line of scrimmage. They've got some good momentum going here, so let's see if they can carry it into the end zone. As the ball's on the ground, but Eamon Centrella smartly, wisely picks it up and hands it off to number 8, Masciarelli. Not much doing on that play, but a nice job by the Rockets to maintain possession as they come up second down. Rockets in a I formation, wide receiver right, quarterback under center. And it's Centrella who is the quarterback as he gives it to Masciarelli, who does a nice job of kind of shaking and baking back and forth to find the hole in the line that was created by 71 Donahue, 42 Vedant Narayan. And the Rockets are going to have it third down, 5 yards, 4 yards to go for the first.
Third and 5 for the Rockets.
Back in the I formation with the wide receiver right. And it's a pitch pass to Masciarelli, who does a nice job of getting outside. He's got some room along the outside. Number 21, Aiden Beckenhuis, did a great job of helping out with the block along with number 41, Sean Crowley. Number 70, Brady Swanson. And a host of Reading Rockets were down there. Jason Anderson, number 50, to help out on the play. As Rockets come back up to the line of scrimmage. Going like a well-oiled machine right now. Firing on all cylinders. Masciarelli keeps the ball, but we've got a flag on the play. It looked like there might have been an offsides on that. Maybe the defender for Acton Boxborough was able to get into the backfield relatively quickly. And we have a false start. So they're going to back it up 5 yards. Or it'll be first and 15. Wow. The Rockets come back out to the line of scrimmage. They've got wide receiver left, I formation, power I formation. Ball's on the ground. And it looks like Acton Boxborough may have jumped on it. They're celebrating. Yes, and they did. So Acton Boxborough jumps on the ball. Unfortunate break for the Rockets, as they will now go back on defense. All right, so after the turnover, the Colonials come up to the line of scrimmage. The quarterback is going to drop back. He's looking for the receiver. And ball falls incomplete. Second down. All right, let's look for New England. Rockets looking to stop the Colonials here. The ball is on the ground. And yeah, Acton Boxborough is going to keep the ball. Looked like the Rockets were, they were certainly around the ball, but they weren't able to come up with it. But the Colonials still got a ways to go. They're looking about 3rd and 8 for the first down. As they come up to the line of scrimmage. Going with a, looks like trips left. Quarterback in the shotgun. He's gonna try to keep it. Great job by number 50, Jason Anderson, to get into the backfield and disrupt the play. Excellent job by number 50. As Musciarelli was able to ultimately stop him. And the Colonials are gonna have it 4th and 10 here. Be interesting to see if they're going to punt on this one. They're at their own, looks like, 14-yard line. So we got a timeout on the field. 4th down, 11 yards to go. The Colonials do look like they're going to, it is going to be a punt. It's an interesting, the Rockets were not fooled on that play at all, where the Colonials, they hiked it to the quarterback in the shotgun, and then he kind of pitched it back to the guy who was gonna, the kid who was going to punt the ball. But the Rockets were not fooled on that at all. The defensive line came charging in. Great job, heads up play, and they will get the ball 1st and 10 from the Colonial 28. All right, Rockets come out. They've got the wide receiver left. Musciarelli's going to keep it. He gets a nice seal block by number 71, Colin Donahue. Number 80, Dylan Sweetser. Number 81, Zachary Galvin.
Ball on the 15-yard line.
All did a great job in blocking there, as Musciarelli was able to pick up about 7 yards on the play. Is Newick? All right. Rockets come out, wide receiver right, Beckenhues as the quarterback. And he's wrapped up behind the line of scrimmage. You could hear the coaches calling for an offsides, but the refs not going to give it to him. So it's going to bring up 3rd down and about 4 yards to go. As the Rockets obviously looking to convert here. Number 22, Jordan Whitmer out there to help out.
3rd and 4 for Reading.
The offensive line gets set. And Musciarelli's trying to follow his blockers. He had number 71, Colin Donahue, out there blocking for him again. Number 21, Aiden Beckenhues. He's able to get the 1st down, but we have an injury on the field. Okay. Number 8, Musciarelli was a little banged up on the play, but he looks like he's all right. That's good to see. As we come back to the play on the field.
Second and goal from the 11.
And we got 2nd down, 11 yards to go. The Rockets are, on the 11-yard line. Rockets come up to the line of scrimmage. Give is to number 21. Beckenhues, he's got a hole. Really nice job again by the offensive line. Number 70, Brady Swanson. Number
21, Aiden Beckenhues.
Number 80, Dylan Sweetser. all doing a great job. Third down, 5 yards to go for the touchdown. The give is, well, it was kept that time by number 8, Mascherelli. Looks like there might have been a little bit of miscommunication on the play. It's about a yard loss there. It's going to bring up fourth down. About 6 yards to go for the touchdown as we got a timeout on the field. All right, the Rockets got fourth down. They got 6 yards to go as the give is to, looked like it was to number 3, Braden Nowicki. He does a really good job. No, I'm sorry, that was number 6.
Number 6, Giacomo Iapica.
Giacomo Iapica, but
turnover on downs.
Colonials are able to stop them there, and they will take over on downs as we start the fourth quarter here. The Rockets have a lead of 14. Excuse me, the Rockets are up 14-6. The Colonials do have the ball. They're well deep inside their own territory, inside the 10-yard line at the 9. They got the wide receiver, twins wide receiver left. Donahue's not fooled at all. Sniffed that out, did a great job. Along with number 21, Aiden Beckenhuis, number 50, Jason Anderson. As to bring up second down and 11. All right, Rocket defense. Looking to stop him here. Nice job by Beckenhuis. There was a really a big hole right there, but Beckenhuis did a good job of getting in there to stop him. The Colonials were able to get a first down out of it, but it could have been a lot worse. Number 72, Sean Murphy, also in there to help out. Number 33, Carter Leonard, as well to help out. Colonials get it first down. Give us to the quarterback. And he's stopped after about a yard on the play, bringing up third down.
There is
a flag on the play. It looks like there might have been a false start against Acton Boxborough as they were trying to. Yep. They were trying to go for the pass there, but somebody moved. Back them up 5. After the false start, the Colonials come up to the line of scrimmage. They're on their own 14-yard line. Two wide receivers, quarterback in the shotgun. He's going deep. Nice attempt. Good spiral. Just lands incomplete. Bringing up third down. Quarterback is going to try the pass attempt again. Falls incomplete. Bringing up fourth and about 14 for the Rockets to try to stop them. All right, big fourth down here for the Colonials. Fourth and 14. They're trying the reverse, but number 33, Carter Leonard, stopped him as he was pursued by number 71, Colin Donahue, came around from the backside to sandwich him in there and stop or get the turnover. So it's going to be first down for the Rockets. They're well inside the Acton Boxborough territory at the 14-15-yard line. All right. Rockets looking to punch it in here. Get the insurance touchdown, as they say. It's a pitch. To number 21, Beckenhuis. Does a good job following his blockers. Gets about 3 yards on the play.
Number 21,
brings it inside the 10-yard line at the 9. Second and 5. Rockets come up to the line of scrimmage. And the ball is given
run by number six,
to number six, Giacomo Iapica. Gains about 3 yards on the play.
Picks up two on the play.
And it's going to be third and two. All right. Rockets trying to convert to the first down. Ball's given to 21 Beckenhuis. And, oh, it is a fumble on the play. The Colonials get it back at their own, about the 11-yard line, where they'll take over first and 10. All right. The Rockets trying to hold on to a 14-6 lead here, probably about halfway through the fourth quarter.
Tommy Ruffley picks up two on the play.
Running back gets about 2 yards on the play, bringing up second and eight. They are staying in the hurry up. And
to number 24, Cameron McGinty.
Rockets were not fooled. They were in position as number 40. Jack James makes a great solo tackle right there by the legs. Great job by number 40, Jack James. Dad man in the camera here is going to be proud of that one. As the Rockets try to hold him here, third down. 5 yards, 6 yards to go. And again, they're not stopped. Excellent defense so far. Number 40 again in on the play, along with number 33. Carter Leonard, number 71. Donahue in there as well. So, wow, this Rocket defense is playing up to tune here.
Fourth
down, 6 yards to go. All right. Got to stop him here. Quarterback's going back. It's a pass. It's incomplete.
Pass by number five, Tommy Ruffley.
Nice attempt by the Colonials, but the Rockets convert, take over on downs, first and 10. Oh, wow. All right, Rockets. First down. They're at the 8 yard line. The ball is given to number 21, Aiden Beckenhuis. Keeps his feet moving and gets about 3 yards on the play, where we're going to get a timeout, Acton Boxborough. Rockets come up to the line of scrimmage. Second down, 8 yards to go. The pitch is to number 21, Beckenhuis, who gets back to the line of scrimmage. And we've got another timeout on the field. All right, here comes the Rockets. They're in a third down, 6 yards to go for the first, about eight for the touchdown. The handoff is to number 21, Beckenhuis, who does an excellent job of keeping his feet, following his blockers. 72. Sean Murphy was there blocking for him, along with number 81, Zachary Galvin, number 42, Vedant Narayan, and a host of Reading Rocket blockers. We've got fourth down, 1 yard to go for the touchdown. About four, first 1 yard for the first down, four for the touchdown, as the ball is given to number 21, Aiden Beckenhuis, drives ahead, first down. They got a first and goal from the 2 yard line. Rockets come up to the line of scrimmage, looking to punch one more in here. The ball is given to number six, Iapica.
Run by number six, Giacomo.
And looks like a timeout, Reading. All right. Second down, 3 yards to go for the touchdown. Mascherelli ultimately ended up keeping it himself. Not sure if it was a busted play on there, but did a smart job to hold on to it. And it's going to be third down, 4 yards to go. Rockets come up in a very tight formation. Mascherelli under center. He's going to give it to number 21, Beckenhuis, who plows ahead. And touchdown, number 21. Aiden Beckenhuis, as the ref gives the signal. The Rockets go in and go up 20-6. All right, the Rockets, after the touchdown, come up to the line of scrimmage, looking to punch an extra one in for the extra point here. And the ball is kept by Mascherelli as the extra point is no good, but the Rockets with a nice lead here, 20-6, with probably about a minute or two left in the game.
Tyler Clayton and number 34.
Rockets set to kick off here. Number 6, Giacomo Iapica. Give it a nice kick, and he does, as the ball is picked up by the return man. He's still on his feet. He's following the blockers. We got a flag on the play as the active Boxborough return man is able to bring the ball back all the way for what could be a touchdown, but it is a hold against Acton Boxborough. So unfortunately, that ball is gonna come back, and really a nice special teams job by Acton Boxborough, but the holding is gonna bring it back, probably right about midfield, so that's where the Rockets will go on defense. All right, so actually an unfortunate break there for the Colonials, because it really was a nice return, but you can't hold, and that's what happened. So the Rockets, Colonials will get it at midfield. They're at the 50-yard line. Shotgun, quarterback's in the shotgun, three receiver set, as the ball is given to the running back, who gets back to the line of scrimmage. And it looks like that's going to do it, folks, as the time has expired, I believe. Maybe a little bit of confusion out there. And nope, looks like they're going to have at least one more play left. As the Rockets were kind of cheering maybe a little prematurely over there on the sideline, But it's going to be second down, 10 yards to go. I would guess this probably is the last play of the game. Three receiver set. And they're going to go with a quick screen. And the running back, the wide receiver has some room. As now time has officially expired. So your Reading Rocket D squad walks away with a 20-6 win, picking up a very well-deserved win as they came out here looking to get that win, and they did. They played an excellent game, a really hard-fought game. Great blocking, great tackling, just the fundamentals of the game were working that way today, and that's what gave them the win. So, once again, your Reading Rockets win at Acton Boxborough, 20-6, and we'll see you next week against Wilmington at home. All right.